This couple are going to work. There is a dog sitting in the middle of the street and staring at them. The man honks loudly to drive him away, but he sits still on the street staring at them. So they get out of the car and slowly approach him. The wife talks with the dog. Suddenly he stands up and runs to the car and sits on the back seat. The couple helpless look at him. They take him to Dampier, Western Australia. This is a true story in the 70s of the last century. People from over the world go to Dampier, where is the largest iron mine in the world. After arriving here, Red Dog is very sociable living with the workers. The worker far from his hometown tells Red Dog about homesickness story. When being bored, he often plays with him. Red Dog takes tenderness and warmth to this boring and bleak world. Anyone can get close to him, but he doesn't belong to anyone, because he belongs to everyone in the big family here. Red Dog loves to sit in the car to go sightseeing, and runs up into the vast deserts. He takes cars, containers and even trains to hang out. That day, a new bus driver named John comes to the town. John doesn't know the regulation here, so he asks Red Dog to get off. And Red Dog is also very obedient and sits by the side of the street. And he looks pitifully at John because he wants to get in John's bus. But John doesn't care him. One day, after working, John goes to the pub and sees a crowd surrounding Red Dog. He voraciously eats the canned food contained the bowl. That crowd is betting on how long he eats. Although these people really like Red Dog, they don't know actually they are harming him. They bring a raw chicken to Red Dog to eat. Seeing that, John prevents them and also fights with a bald man. While they are fighting, Red Dog begins to bark frantically. The dog that is gently every day is now going crazy. That makes the bald man afraid. There is one thing that amazes everyone. Red Dog, which doesn't belong to anyone, obediently follows John out of the pub and is gotten in John's bus. Now Red Dog has a real owner, and this is the only owner in his life. The girl with blonde hair is called Nancy. When she gets in the bus, all the men swap seats to sit by the windows, quickly brush the messy beards and stare at Nancy. Nancy is a bit confused. She sees Red Dog is sitting in the first row, but he doesn't know what a beautiful woman is. "Go down," said Nancy. "Don't understand," Red Dog replied. "Be a polite dog, move by a side." Now, when getting in the bus, John sees Nancy is sitting next to Red Dog. He politely greets her. This is the first time they meet. After that, John has many chances to talk with Nancy. Their relationship is gradually close. That day, John invites Nancy to watch film outside. She agrees with him. That night, John takes Red Dog to his friend's house. He doesn't want Red Dog to see them when they are kissing. This is a peaceful and beautiful night. Obviously, John and Nancy are not really interested in the movie. Suddenly, there is a black shadow on the screen. Red Dog suddenly appears in front of them. He isn't happy with Nancy because she takes over his love, but he can't do anything. Their feelings are more and more passionate, like the sun in the desert. They and Red Dog live happily together. One day, John invites his colleagues to his house and organizes a party. He suddenly turns off the music, then stands up in the trunk and claims that, after more than 10 years traveling everywhere, John now wants to settle here because he loves Nancy. John proposes to Nancy. Nancy happily agrees. They hug tightly each other. After the party, John takes Nancy to her home by motorbike. Everything seems to be going well. The next day, John says goodbye to Nancy and drives home. The sun in the early morning is just beautiful, not too hot. A cool breeze blows. Everything is so beautiful. The motorbike goes through each sun flap. John gradually disappears on the road. That afternoon, John still doesn't go to work. His colleague calls Nancy. She says John came back home very early. Everyone begins to find him. Halfway, they see the body of a kangaroo and a long skid track on the road. When they find out John, he left this life. Red Dog doesn't know his owner passed away. He is still waiting for John in the door and quietly looks toward the road that John used to go. Everyone is extremely sad. Until the funeral is over, they suddenly remember Red Dog. John's colleague wants to bring Red Dog home to look after, but he is only loyal to John. He sits there waiting exactly 1 month and just stares at the end of the road in order to wait for a familiar person to appear. One day, Red Dog decides that if his owner doesn't return, he will look for John. Even he has to go over the world. Red Dog comes to the bus station and looks at each person in turn, like asking them, "Have you seen my owner?" They regretfully shook their heads at him. The journey to find the owner of Red Dog officially starts. He goes through salt fields, shopping malls, pubs. He goes against the direction of the sun, in the hope that he can find the light of his life in the endless night. From the desert to the mountain, it seems that everywhere in Western Australia he has passed. Red Dog even gets on a cargo ship that goes from a seaport in Australia to the coast of Japan. However, everything is in vain. Going through a journey of many difficulties, he also realizes that his owner doesn't return anymore. So he decides to come back home. Nancy sees Red Dog as if she sees her child that has been lost for many years. Red Dog returns to this big family, but he ate poisonous food, so his health is not good as before. Red Dog sees everyone being tumultuous, and he immediately leaves. When people find out, he left, and then they quickly find Red Dog. Finally, they see him in front of John's grave. He will take a long sleep here. People are extremely regretful and painful, because they don't see Red Dog as a dog. He is a member of the family. A man who used to be saved by Red Dog takes off his shirt to cover him. Under the bright sunlight, in front of the tombstone, there is an incredible beauty showing up. Perhaps, death for Red Dog is also a blessing. He's possible to reunite his owner in another world.